When Scott Strickland had a press conference at the University of Florida on Tuesday, September 27th, and it was made apparent to me that I would have a chance, an opportunity, to interview for the athletic director's position at Mississippi State. I knew that I could not meet with Dr. Keenum or anybody else about this position without having a coaching candidate in my back pocket. I felt like that was really important. Mississippi State baseball is too important to not have that in place. I want to tell you, for the last month, I've gotten to my office between 6 and 6:30. I have gone to D1 baseball. I've gone to several websites and looked at the coaches that represent 290-plus Division I programs in the country. Assistants, head coaches, guys in professional baseball, guys in junior college baseball, guys at all levels of baseball. And once you looked at the needs of Mississippi State baseball, at this great institution, in this great league, it was apparent to me that we were going to have a pretty small pool of guys. We needed somebody who was going to have the ability to evaluate and recruit. We needed somebody who had a keen knowledge of the baseball game, keen knowledge of the game. We had to have somebody who had the ability to connect and teach students to student athletes. We had to have somebody who had a great path to get here in terms of role models. We had to have a guy who had an unbelievable knowledge of the Southeastern Conference. We had to have somebody who had an incredible rapport with professional baseball. We had to have someone who was known around the country and had a national reputation in collegiate baseball. We had to have somebody who was a relentless recruiter at the Division I and Southeastern Conference level. And we had to have someone who understood and valued education, not only for student athletes, but for himself and for his family. And after going through that criteria, I realized that Andy Cannizaro was going to be our guy. In terms of evaluating and recruiting, I think he's one of the best in the entire country, if not the best. And I had the opportunity this summer, because of the nature of our staff, the turnover of our staff, I got to spend a lot of time with Andy. And the way he broke down the game, the way he evaluated players, the way he approached players, I thought was outstanding. His knowledge of the game is outstanding. Perhaps one of the things that really struck me the most about Andy was the fact that not only did he have a tremendous knowledge, he had a thirst for more knowledge and searched out information, always wanting to get better. His ability to connect with student athletes, just reading the tweets that have come from LSU and from several folks around the country about what he has meant to them and the way he's connected with student athletes that he has worked with, it is really incredible. Andy played for a guy named Joe Madden, the manager of the Chicago Cubs. He played for a guy named Joe Torre. He worked with many of the people high up in the Yankees organization, Damon Oppenheimer. Damon Oppenheimer for the state. Damon, if you don't mind standing up, from the New York Yankees came all the way to visit us today. He worked directly with Brian Cashman, the general manager of the New York Yankees. He played for and was recruited by Jim Schlossnagel at TCU, then at Tulane, who has spoken, said tremendous things about Andy. And he played for Rick Jones, one of the great coaches in all of Division I baseball. One of the other unique things about Andy to me is this. The fact that he was a scout, a professional baseball scout for the New York Yankees. He covered this area of the Deep South. His connections with other scouts around the country and in our area. But also, the fact that he had spent a ton of time in duty Noble Field, evaluating our players and players around the Southeastern Conference. And then later being in the dugout, in the opposing dugout, at Duty Noble Field. So he has many different optic views of the Southeastern Conference. 7.5 years as a scout in our area and as a recruiting coordinator and assistant coach in the Southeastern Conference. His rapport with professional baseball, outstanding. I have tried, in an indirect way, I have tried to find folks in professional baseball who would say something bad about Andy. It didn't happen. It was amazing. Because had it been reversed, Andy could have found an unbelievable amount of people to say bad things about John Cohen, I guarantee you that. But I couldn't find it. And it was amazing. In speaking to Andy, one word just keeps coming up over and over and over again when you talk to him, and that's opportunity. He kept saying what an incredible opportunity he had as a major league baseball player before getting injured. What an incredible opportunity he had as a collegiate player. He's a great one. He's a two-time All-American, maybe one of the greatest players in Tulane history. He's in the Tulane Baseball Hall of Fame. He's an honor roll student at Tulane University, an outstanding academic institution. But more than anything, I look at the decisions that Andy has made. And I think one of the great decisions he has made, maybe the best, is the decision sitting two away from his wife, Allison, who is an absolute all-star. Allison, it's been great to get to know you. She will add so much to the Mississippi State family, the community of Starkville, and the state of Mississippi. I could stand up here all day and give you all the qualifications that Andy Cannizaro brings to this position, but I want to reiterate something. I told our club Friday afternoon, I reiterated this to them. They're not going to get a coach as good as John Cohen. We're getting a better one than John Cohen, there's no doubt in my mind. So at this time, I would like to introduce new baseball coach at Mississippi State University, Andy Cannizaro.
SEC championship team from a year ago. Our entire team is in the back of the room today, so I want to thank you guys for being here. I'm looking forward to being your head coach. I'm looking forward to leading you guys into the future, and I'm looking forward to having an amazing baseball season. Thank you guys for being here. I'd also like to thank the amazing turnout we have here today. I mean, I think it just continues to show how high of an interest level everyone has in Mississippi State baseball. Thank you guys for being here. I look forward to seeing you at Duty Noble this spring. We can't wait to get after it with you guys in the stands. Thank you for being here. There are several people that I would like to thank that are here today that have a major, major role in my upbringing, in my young 20s, and now into my late 30s, basically having impacted my entire life. The first person I would like to thank for being here today is my amazing wife, Allison. I met Allison at Tulane University back in 1999. Here we are in 2016, and I absolutely hit the jackpot. She's the best and smartest person I've ever met in my life. 11-year practicing attorney, graduating the top 3% of her law school, and she's the most amazing wife and the most incredible mother I could have ever imagined for my children. I love you very much. My mom and dad, Gary and Susan Cannizaro, just all the years of either coaching me, sitting in the stands and watching me all over the country. She's had 3 sons that have played the game. I promise you, she didn't know what she was signing up for when she met my dad years ago. She's probably seen more baseball than anybody in this room. And thank you for going everywhere and watching us play. Gabrielle and Pierce, my amazing little girl, my phenomenal little boy, just 2 of the greatest miracles I could have ever asked for. Allison's smart like her mama. Gabrielle is smart like her mama. Allison's smart like her mom, too. Gabrielle is smart like her mom. And Pierce is a left-handed hitting shortstop that doesn't swing and miss. Some of my college coaches, John had mentioned Rick Jones and Jim Schlossnagel. I want to thank those guys for giving me the opportunity to attend Tulane University. It was the school that I dreamed of about when I was growing up and wanting to play at. My dad was an assistant coach there. I bat boyed there when I was 5, 6, 7 years old. It was a dream come true to play there. I was extremely lucky to play for Rick Jones and Jim Schlossnagel. So I want to thank those guys for shaping my college career and helping me get to the level that I could to get into professional baseball. Once I got into professional baseball, like John had mentioned, I was extremely fortunate enough to play for so many great minor league managers and coaches along the way. But the two that I would like to recognize and thank and mention today are Joe Torre and Joe Madden. You're talking about a Hall of Fame manager in Joe Torre and probably the best manager in baseball today in Joe Madden. Being around those guys in my mid-20s allowed me to see the type of leader that I wanted to be, knowing that when my baseball career finished, I wanted to get into coaching. I wanted to get into scouting. I wanted to stay in baseball. Seeing how those guys handled superstar players, Joe Torre managing teammates of mine like Derek Jeter and Alex Rodriguez and Robinson Cano, Bernie Williams, Mariano Rivera. Being around those guys every single day with the New York Yankees showed me how you have to carry yourself as a professional to be great at the game. And then several years later with the Tampa Bay Rays, being a part of that young team that ultimately played in the World Series later, that October. So I had two managers that had managed a veteran-laden team and a young, energetic group that got to the World Series. So just every single day that I was around those guys, I was able to take in different things that I knew I wanted to bring with me when I was able to get into the coaching world. So I want to thank those guys and everybody in those organizations with the New York Yankees and Tampa Bay Rays. After my playing career ended, I was extremely fortunate enough to go into the scouting world and take an amazing job and opportunity from the New York Yankees, where I was able to work for 5 years under the scouting director and one of the vice presidents for the New York Yankees, Damon Oppenheimer. Damon was an incredible mentor. He was an incredible role model. He taught me so many great things about player and talent evaluation that I continue to use to this day, trying to soak up as much as I can from him. Was something that I knew would benefit me for the rest of my life. So I'm incredibly grateful. Damon, thank you very much for all your time you spent with me. Thank you for letting me represent the New York Yankees at the Major League Baseball Draft. It was an amazing time in my life. Thank you very much. Several other mentors that I would love to mention today include one of Damon's co-workers, assistant to Brian Cashman, Jim Hendry. Jim Hendry was the former general manager for the Chicago Cubs, an amazing baseball man with so much knowledge that I was constantly picking his brain all the time from. An amazing, amazing baseball man that I consider a great friend to this day and keep in touch with all the time, and is always there for me to answer any questions I have. Several other mentors in professional baseball include Brian Cashman, the general manager for the New York Yankees. Being in charge of the greatest organization in professional sports is really incredible, and the success that he's had there is something that I've always looked up to. Personal friends with the Los Angeles Dodgers president, Andrew Friedman, that was a college classmate of mine, that's probably now one of the top front office guys in Major League Baseball. So I've had this opportunity to be around so many incredible baseball people that have truly shaped my life over the years. Everything that I learned in the player and talent evaluation world of professional baseball, I was able to bring with me to Louisiana State University. I was able to spend the last 2.5 years there coaching at LSU, being the recruiting coordinator, and using all the things that I learned from all these people that I had mentioned every day. I absolutely loved my job with the New York Yankees, but I knew that I had this drive to get on the field and be able to coach and teach and help young baseball players maximize their ability on the field. The last 2.5 years coaching at LSU have been some of the very best times of my life. The relationships that I've built with those players are ones that I will remember for the rest of my life. I look at all those guys, and they've had some of the biggest impact on my career. Outside of me playing in the big leagues, coaching those group of guys, it's been one of the coolest things I've done in this game. I'd like to mention several of those guys, starting with players like Alex Bregman, Andrew Stevenson, Kate Savick, and finishing with guys like Kramer Robertson, Cole Freeman, Greg Dyke, and Antoine Plantis. Those are just some of the guys that have absolutely touched my heart over the last 2.5 years, and I will love those kids for the rest of my life. While coaching at LSU, I was able to work for a Hall of Fame head coach in Paul Maneri. Paul Maneri was an amazing man to work for every day. His knowledge of the game, his understanding of what it takes to run a program was simply incredible. Had his pulse on everything that happened in the program. Every day that I went to work for Paul Maneri, I went with my eyes and ears open. He was an incredible man to be around for the last 2.5 years, and I feel like being around Paul has truly prepared me to be the next head baseball coach at Mississippi State. So I want to thank Paul Maneri from the bottom of my heart for giving me that opportunity to be coach at LSU. I want to thank our entire coaching staff at LSU, pitching coach Alan Dunn, assistant Nolan Kane and baseball operations guy Micah Gibbs for being an amazing group to go to work with every day with an awesome office environment. Thank you guys very much. I touched earlier about how honored and how privileged I am to be the head coach here at Mississippi State. We're talking about a program that has so much pride, so much tradition, so much national recognition. I'm blown away that at 37 years old that I was selected to be the head coach of this prestigious program. My family is extremely honored to be the newest member of the Mississippi State baseball family. So I want to thank Dr. Keenum. I want to thank John Cohen for giving me this amazing opportunity to lead this program into the future. John Cohen has done an incredible job at his alma mater, Mississippi State University. And you don't replace a head coach like John Cohen. You continue to build upon all the great things that he's done for this program. Just a few short years ago, this program competed for the national championship, for the national championship game. What I want to do is continue to work, continue to grind, and continue to coach as hard as I can with our staff to help our players achieve our goal. Our goal here at Mississippi State University is to win the national championship. And there's only one way to make that happen. And we talked about that with our players in our first team meeting the other night. Is we need to work as hard as we possibly can. Every single day, give me everything you got. I will give you everything I have. Our coaching staff will give you everything we have to make you guys maximize your skill level. And if we can have each one of you guys performing at your highest level possible, then together as a team, we will be in Omaha, and we will be dogpiling on the mound, and we will be celebrating our first national championship. That's our goal, that's my goal, that's our coaching staff's goal, that's our amazing administration's goal, and our players have the same exact goal. We are going to do everything in our power to bring that first national championship back to Starkville and Mississippi State University. We've got returning All-Americans. We've got returning draft picks that elected to come back to school and continue to get their degree, earn more degrees. I just want you guys to know that competing against you guys last year in the SEC was a lot of fun because you guys played hard. There was intensity. There was a serious swagger with you guys every single day. And I'm so fired up to be a part of what you guys have built here. We're going to continue to do it. We're going to do it big. There's a really big scoreboard, a massive scoreboard that's going up in the right field. And I tell our guys, every time we turn that scoreboard on, we are going to light it up. We're going to play the classic style of baseball. We're going to hit. We're going to run. We're going to defend. We're going to pound the strike zone, we're going to steal bases, we're going to put pressure on the defense, we're going to play an amazingly fun brand of baseball that's going to be extremely entertaining to the greatest fans in college baseball. I cannot tell you guys how excited I am, okay, to be a part of this Mississippi State baseball family, and I'm looking forward to building on all the amazing things that you guys have built. Starting back with Ron Polk, Pat McMahon, John Cohen, Will Clark, Rafael Palmeiro, Jeff Brandt, Bobby Thigpen, to this generation's Adam Frazier's, Hunter Renfro's, And the two guys that I was fortunate enough to draft with the New York Yankees that Damon Oppenheimer ultimately selected, and Jacob Lindgren and Jonathan Holder. Guys, I can't mention everyone that's been a part of this program, but I want you guys to know all these names that we just mentioned have built this program. And this group that we have on the field this year, and the groups that we have coming, we've got tremendously talented kids that are coming to Mississippi State. They've done an incredible job recruiting. We're going to continue to build on all the recruiting things that have happened here in Mississippi State. And we're going to win that first national championship. We're going to have a blast playing baseball, and I cannot wait to see everybody out at the Dude this spring. All right? So thank you guys very much. I'm extremely honored, and I can't wait to get started. Hail State!